So I'm out here at this car show. I forgot to tell you guys, I got the BMW back. Built motor, right? We'll go through the list of things. I'll post it below. But pretty much CP pistons, manly HB rods, stock 10-2, 0.5:1, I believe, is the compression ratio. I got the block grill for 11mm studs. Drilled and time started by Billy Orton, who's a fantastic engine builder, especially if you have M54, man. Really trustworthy guy. So if you want your motor built, go to him, unless you got somebody else, but that's my suggestion. Anyway, I'm out here at this car show. I'll show you guys a little walk around my car. I'll show you guys the damage it's got, because I trailered it myself on the back of the SRTG. So I'm gonna get the things fixed, but there are things that I gotta get fixed on this car. But overall, I'll show you guys what I got done, and then I'm at a car show, so I'll show you guys some other cars, man. Appreciate you guys being out here with me. So as you guys can see, it's back up and running. 67mm turbo. It's kind of dirty. I was actually on the way to go clean the car, and then I seen a car show, so I said I might as well start doing the video. All right, so first things first to get fixed, I gotta get the ducts down here, which I took out and I lost them because I moved. Still got the front end cooler. Things I gotta get fixed, like this here, a little gap is in here. This isn't the original bumper that I got done. They did some work to it. As you can see, I got these fender flares here on the side. That was real nice and cool. Little gap still though, as I said, coming through here. I got them all the way around, man. All the way around. Right. But I for sure have some scratches on the trunk now. Right. Some scratches I gotta get fixed. I'm a realist, I still want to fix them. And then, as you can see, I'm missing a flare, fender flare here. But I'll get somebody to touch that up for me. Cause it's just missing it. I probably need some better wheels. We'll get that fixed later. And then one of the big things, I'm gonna try to replace this by myself, but it got hit here and shattered the whole thing up here. So we'll get that fixed as well. But like, we're just breaking the motor in now. I gotta do 400 miles. 400 miles. Breaking period, and then the car should be good to go, man. I should be full sanded after I do the oil change and send pictures of the oil back to my guy. But let's take a walk around and see what we got, man. I'll give you a quick, show of the engine bay here. Got the tiles, the twin tile wastegates, one here, and then one's in the back there. First, let's get some Corvettes, man. We got a Z06 here. This thing's beautiful. That's 427. Okay. Clean. Very clean. I'm not gonna get inside this car or anything like that. I don't do that. He's got camera set up all in here, so it might be putting some people on YouTube or on social media. That's always cool. I don't have enough GoPros. Super sick. I love these things, man. This car is so ahead of its time. Gotta love it. Hilarious. So sick though, man. So ahead of his time, man. Still at the track killing people in these things right now. Doesn't look like much. Maybe catch can over here. Throttle body, or not throttle body, a painted intake manifold. Always sick. Port injection, maybe. Super cool. So fun fact, right? I might have to have you guys, I might give you guys my dad's Instagram, because we've got one of these. Well, he has one of these. I say we because I'm his son, so, you know, I'm gonna claim it because my dad. But, like, he has one of these, a C10, and I really want to build it, but he's kind of hesitant on it right now. We really don't have a lot of time. But I've seen some sick setups where guys have wheelwork brake systems. And other kind of things going on. But I think this is sick. It's definitely on air. I'm assuming that's what this cover is for, by the air tanks. But it is on the ground. So cool. This is where I need to be, right? I think if I have money, I don't know if I'm a McLaren guy. I'm definitely not. I got the pocket for it right now, right? But I think I'd be a Viper guy,
a TRX Viper guy. I have both.
Look, you know how expensive these rotors are? Man, I've looked at these rotors; are very expensive. Two-piece rotors. I want to say they're like carbon fiber. If I'm wrong, put it in the comments. But holy crap, this is—you can't hide money, man. You know, even smells amazing. But now it's crazy. That's 2,000 every once in a while. No?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Very great fitment on the wheels with no spacers. Might have some spacers. I think I see some spacers. But it's still amazing fitment. I got spacers a lot. And S2Ks are so cool looking. So, digital gauge cluster. Carbon fiber trunk, the carbon fiber ducklet added to the trunk. I don't know what this is called, but I remember having it as a kid, and they called it a hot rod. And it's so cool. I kind of got into LSs for a little bit, and then I took a different route. I was going to put one in the 335i, but I ended up not doing it, so. I think we have the same wheels. This thing's sick. SS. Massive intake manifold. Probably has a large hood scoop if he ever runs a hood, or unless it's garage kept. Sick SS. Dodge stole this idea from me because I had my wide body on in Germany in 2015. I'm just kidding. I actually did, but I just think these things look so good, man. As you know, I got a 392 myself. They don't look this good. The wheels, the Brembos. That's what made me really love Dodge. I didn't know they had two pieces on. Mine is a 2014, so it does not. Ashtray, but it is weird walking away from your car with like the windows open and all the things I was told not to do when I was older. So, but key's not in there, and whatever. Let's check out some more cars. This car, and I used to help him work up on it all the time, really just to get it running. But growing up, me and him as a kid, you know, sit in the car for hours, almost like, you know, 10 hours a day trying to get this thing to run. He wasn't a mechanic, he was figuring it out, and that's one of the things that really got me into cars. Show some love to the SRT Jeep, because you know I got one of these too. Let's paint it. I want to get mine painted. Man, it smells like weed over here. Anyway, the SRT Jeeps. Very versatile vehicles. So beautiful, man. Probably the most versatile vehicle I've ever driven. And then a step up. Hellcat Durango. Still want a Hellcat Durango or a Hellcat bigger vehicle, let's say. So maybe a TRX or Hellcat Durango. Sorry, I said that again. Or a Trackhawk. But I don't know if it justifies spending right now because of some things we're trying to do. So hats off to anybody that can afford this thing right now, because they are expensive and dealers are going crazy right now trying to up the prices on these things. Beautiful. Rush 50. Sorry, man. Okay. Greatest idea Mustang has had. Throwing a Whipple on it, dude. Jeez. Yo, one of the coolest things ever. Just like, you know, one of the coolest things ever is just like, hey, I have a 5.0 right now. What should I do to make it cooler? Let's throw a Whipple on it, you know, a little bit of boost, and let's make the tires just break off as soon as you hit the gas. Oh, and it also is going to sound absolutely amazing. So, you know, I love the big tire, the small tire, I guess that's what you call it. Call them the thickies. I love the thickies. They're expensive though. They are amazing. Beautiful car. So there's two things that I come to a car meet for. And I gotta see it before I go home, and I know it's gonna be there. One thing is the GTR, right? You know you're gonna see a GTR. And the other thing is a Hellcat, right? I just showed you the Hellcat Durango, but I mean like an actual, like, not the SUV, which SUV is super impressive too, actually, if not more impressive, but also the Hellcats, like the Challengers and Chargers. So I gotta show you one. Got to. We can't get out of here without that. And then I'm gonna go wash the car, take a little video of that, and then we'll keep moving on the day. Thank you.
so like comfortable inside.
El Camino. Straight classic, man. Look at that. Valve covers look amazing.
This dude knew there was a car show today. Clearly, he makes one of us. But that's the best thing about the old schools, or when you have the, I don't know if they call them chrome or they call them silver valve covers, and they're just so clean. The sun's hitting. Just like the grill. Look at that. Look at that right there. That sun right there.
El Camino. I don't know. You guys let me know if it's the same. My dad is more of a Chevy guy. Well, a few more cars and we'll hit the road.
Oh, I guess I gotta show you guys just how beautiful this thing is.
All original on the inside. The way it should be. Alright guys, last one I promise. Alright, so here you go. V58. Maybe upgraded turbo. Definitely a downpipe. Probably 85. And the pickies. Gotta love them. They move out. Colorado M5X, he's got one. Brian. And it's new stuff. Hell out. He's also, he's got a top mount single turbo. But yeah, these things are quick. It's funny because I used to tell people when this thing first came out, it was the huge debate was this versus the C6, or not C6, the C8 was a huge debate. Because they were around like the same price and people were laughing. They were like, well, if I pay $60,000 for this, I'll pay $60,000 for the C8. Obviously, the dealer shut that down and started selling the C8s for like $100K or more. Maybe a little less if you're really good at finding it. But these things ended up being just as quick as the old school ones. People were saying like, oh, I'd rather have a 2J. Yeah, everybody would rather have a 2J, but BMW makes them really, really, really fast inline six. It's probably the best at it at this point in the game. And why wouldn't Toyota hit up BMW and say, hey man, build me one of those inline sixes with a little turbocharger on it. And let's freaking go fast and break records and take us back to the glory days of the 90s Toyota Supra. That was so cool. I don't think it makes as cool noises as that one, but for sure, it's fast. So cool. Very beautiful. It's always weird. These engine bays are so small. I would never want to have to work on this. I bet you have to drop the motor from the bottom. If I'm wrong, just let me know. But I'm pretty sure you do. And then the Hellcat. Hellcats are just fun, man. You spin the tires on it. Definitely made me. I drove a. The first like style car like that was the just the regular Hemi 345, and it made me buy the SRT Jeep, and I was like, yeah, that's all the power I really need. And of course now I have a Whipple, which I still have to put on, but we're gonna force the motor, guys. I've been reading a lot of horror stories about stock bottom
392. We're going to forge the motor on that thing, and then we are going to get it going. Obviously, when I forge it, we're just going to be pistons
because they're dropping, and they'll hold the 5-6 pounds that I want to do. Maybe 8. We'll say 8 pounds. We'll go 8 pounds. Probably run about 8 pounds, and then we'll leave it at that. I just don't want I know the ZF transmission is really strong, but I don't want the other issues. I'm not trying to break any records on that thing. I'm not really not trying to break records on mine, but on the 335. But I do want to be able to get on it and, you know, surprise a few people in traffic when a 5,500 pound SUV comes flying by you. So just want a little bit more than stock track hawk power. Maybe even surprise a couple stock hawks and go from there.
Dude, this thing has a lot of carbon fiber on it, bro. So much.
Not a lot of carbon fiber.
I remember being young and I was like, hey, why does this cost so much? Until you see it in the sun and you realize, like, wow. One thing that I like about the SRTG is that it comes with carbon fiber. You know, those dudes over there, I was like, let me stop by, see what cars they got, and then from there, I guess I'll go wash the car, man. So see you guys when we get there.
They really rapping what you live, bro. I know they say them steppers, yeah, they train to go. I know I heard they vibing to your songs, bro. I know they really rapping what you live, bro. I know they say them steppers, yeah, they train to go. I know I don't know this, but I do know that. But I really got shit to prove. Changing up how we move. Due to the snakes, that's why we traveling too. Busting it too. If my life ever feeling danger on the mic, I'm releasing that anger free smoke. Well, I'm giving them cancer. You want smoke, but ain't got time for that.
They won't be.
You know where to find me at.
We gon' eat,
but we gon' grind for that.
We gon' step.
You know where to find me at.
I know y'all vibing. My music true. I spit the truth. Can't fake the funk. And spit some lies when I'm in the booth. Y'all rock with me. I rock with you. Salute the truth. I'm doing these things you couldn't do. Salute to you.
I heard they vibing to your songs, bro. I know. They really rapping what you live, bro. I know. They say them steppers, yeah, they train to go. I know. I heard they vibing to your songs, bro. I know. They really rapping what you live, bro. I know. They say them steppers, yeah, they train to go. I know.
My music rocking. The streets is mobbing. My partner's robbing. Call me the goblin. No bombs, they dropping. They think I'm falling.
No fear, no options.
But my music, bro, ain't gonna stop. Each month, Tay Mills gonna drop. Like a rubber, Tay Mills gonna pop.
You want smoke, but ain't got time for that.
They won't be.
You know where to find me at.
We gon' eat,
but we gon' grind for that.
We gon' step,
you know where to find me at.
Alright guys, all clean. Obviously we let the tire shine sit for a little bit, but should've went to the car show this way. You know, nice and clean. My good side though, you know, you know, glass work on the other side, but we can get that taken care of. Just like that. Hey. Now, until next time, guys, we're in the team forever. Green the world, baby. We out.